Hoboken Housing Authority Commissioner David Mello. So Commissioner, as you can see, things got a little out of hand at the end there. Something that got some of the attendees here a little aggravated, a little anxious. You introduced a motion and a resolution to do something involving the chairperson. So could you explain that to me?
Well, yeah, it wasn't anything. There was a resolution that I proposed earlier in the meeting that I had written up. And that was to make an amendment to our bylaws, and that would be that if new members are basically come onto the board, that would be a trigger the ability to, not a necessity to, but the ability to take a vote to change the leadership of the board, because the composition of the board had changed.
So
via a new appointment. In this case, there was two new appointments. So I just wanted to propose an amendment to the bylaws, which would make it under our bylaws allowable to call a vote if we so chose, and if a majority vote won out, to change or have another election for the chair and vice chair of our Board of Commissioners.
And just to clarify, you figured that would be a good idea just because you have two new appointees?
I think it's any time the composition of a board changes and potentially the votes on votes and feelings about who should be chair and vice chair would change with the composition of the board, may or may not change. I think the opportunity should be there to take a vote if that newly comprised board so chooses.
And then, for whatever reason, things got pretty heated when you wanted to change the meeting from February 13th to February 20th.
Well, I actually made a motion to put that to vote because one of our new members, I believe, is going to have to participate telephonically at the next meeting because they had booked a trip months ago, before the election was even held for city council and the mayor. And, they can participate telephonically, but that's sometimes awkward and it's not the ideal way to do it. So I just thought, as a courtesy to newly elected members who have, obviously there are situations where they could have made plans months before elections even happened of the people who just appointed them, that it would be just a courteous thing to do to consider changing the date to not have that conflict.
So having said that, why do you think those in attendance here got so riled up about it?
I think it had very little to do with that motion and more to do with just concern that I was trying to make a motion on the fly. They maybe were suspect of that because they feel that they feel that maybe they wouldn't agree with the motion without probably listening to it as clearly as they could. It was a pretty simple thing that I was just trying to make a courtesy to a member who can still participate, but would participate in a more effective and efficient way.
So perhaps maybe they were just confused on what was actually happening since it was getting loud.
I don't know. I mean, maybe it was just a matter, assuming the worst and not really listening to what it was about. I mean, it was a simple courtesy. And I talked to one of my fellow commissioners, Eduardo Gonzalez, about that, and he seemed to understand. I just think that it was a shame, in my opinion, that the chair didn't let us just discuss it so that we could have gotten out there that's why I was trying to change the meeting date. Not because somebody couldn't participate, but because they could participate, not telephonically, but be here in person at the next meeting.
All right, Commissioner.
I think that's ideal.
Because at the end there, Commissioner Mello was trying to make a motion to move the next meeting from February 13th to February 20th, and you wouldn't entertain the motion. So could you just tell me why?
There's no major reason why. When Jake was the chair, everything had to go through the chair. Before that, Jeannie was the chair. And everyone wants to kind of just dance around me. And all I wanted to do was ask all the commissioners when it would be appropriate or what that date was. Does it work for everyone? But he's like, no, I want to know now. How many times have I asked Dave Mello? Dave Mello, we need a meeting, a committee meeting. Can you give us Tuesday? I can't tell you right now. I don't know what I'm doing Tuesday. I got to check my book. These are all things that he says. So what is the difference now with him? Why does he demand me to answer now when he can answer when he wants? Call me Thursday and I'll let you know what I'm doing Friday. That's not how you should do business.
And now, does it concern you with the two new board appointees? A lot of people in the crowd seems to believe that they're in favor of Mayor Zimmer, and therefore they would support a notion to drive you away from the chairmanship.
Absolutely they would. They I understand that Dave Mello appointed these folks, or not appointed, should I say. He recommended them, and then they all voted for them unanimously. So what do we have next? He went right for the throat. He's got two people who he thinks is with him. or who are with him, and now he's going to try to run the whole game. That's why I told him, you don't run the floor until you get the floor. Well, they want to get rid of me before May. In May, they got the majority, so in May, they'll just do the same thing. But they're trying to make it really ugly now and try to kick me out early. Oust the black man is what they're saying. Oust the black man.
All right, Chairman. Thanks for the...